welcome back to this short series of videos learning the eight pieces of brocade qigong. In the previous video, we finished off on step number two, draw the bow to shoot the eagle. Move number three, we prepare to go to move number three by facing our palms together. I'll show that to you. I'm over here. I find my balance. My palms are facing each other. And then as I breathe out, they pass one another. I breathe in. My palms are facing each other. My hands turn. My hand turns and they pass each other as I breathe out and stand up. This move is called separating heaven and earth. My palms face each other as I breathe in and sink down. And my arms stretch out to separate heaven and earth as I breathe out and stand up. I do that one more time. I breathe in and breathe out. Step number three. Let's do step number two first. Step number two. Oh yes, I'm here. I look this way. I prepare to face my palms to one another as I stand up. And I start to separate heaven and earth by breathing out. Sink down, my palms face each other as I breathe in. My hand changes and I breathe out. Good again. I breathe in as I sink down. My palms pass each other and I breathe out. One more time. Breathe in. And breathe out. When I'm standing over here, this hand is a little bit in front of me, but it's nice and relaxed. It's like Tai Chi, it's not anywhere or too far back. It's quite relaxed and horizontal to the floor. This hand is not, I try to put it above my head, but not where I compromise my posture. So what is comfortable for you, but stretch it out. Be careful not to stretch it out and compromise the posture this way or this way. As much as you can stretch it out without compromising your posture. The next move is step number four called shake the tail, sway the head and shake the tail. It looks like this. So I finished this move. I bring my arms to the same height. I form that cross so I can find my balance and go into that deep stance or deeper horse stance. I put my hands on my thighs. I can put them like this. I can put them on my waist. I can put them like this. I prefer to have my thumbs at the back. I then sway my head and shake the tail. I go over this leg down and I come across. I come up and I look to the front. I sway my head. I go down, I go across, I come up, and I look to the front. Sway my head, go down, come across, come up, hands to the same height to form that cross to go to one leg. Something I want to point out to you is when I'm down here and I go across, I lift my head slightly. I don't want my back to be going rolling down. I come down, I lift my head and I come across. I want my back parallel to the floor, but I want it arched. Not arched, but not rounded. So be sure, just put your chin out and come across. You go down this way, at this point, tilt your head and come across. Let's do it. Number three, number four together. So we are here. My hands are at the same height. I form a cross with the left hand in front. I can take that step. I sink down and put my hands on my thighs. I sway my head, go down, tilt my head, come across, come up, look to the front, sway my head, go down, back up, sway your head. To the same height, form that cross to stand up. Let's go from the very beginning. I will be embracing the tree for a few seconds and we go to end of number four. Thank you. much.